Michael Palermo. Stand. Mike moved from Shore Town to Roswell in 2008. He chose this city specifically to make his home for his wife and 1-year-old daughter, Deanna Rose. He has just finished his final requirement to obtain his MBA from Emory University. He has worked in financial services the last 9 years, where he leads a support team that works with corporate clients in negotiating contractual terms. He serves as a subject matter expert in financial reporting. Mr. Palermo, your opening statement.
I also want to thank the Roswell Women's Club for putting this together. I appreciate everybody that was able to come out tonight. We have a very important election in front of us, and I appreciate you being here to really make this very important decision on who you want to serve you. With that, I'm Mike Palermo, and I am here asking you to hire me to serve you on your certain city council. This is very important that I really want to work for you. And with that, I just want to know that I really see and I feel that I've talked to so many residents that also feel that just Roswell is such a great place to live. It has so many great things that it offers. It has strong, established neighborhoods, unique history, and really the best parks anywhere. And with that, my wife and I, we have a 1-year-old, and God willing, our family will grow. And it is just so important that really for the sake of my family and the sake of your families, we need to make sure that Roswell continues to be the best area in all of Metro Atlanta. I am concerned with the direction that City Council has been bringing us. We've all seen this much higher density, really this much higher density development approaching our neighborhoods and our historic places. We need to protect what makes Roswell special. And on top of that, it is irresponsible to rezone when there's not the proper infrastructure in place to support this much higher density. And when I say infrastructure, I'm referring specifically to traffic, really the strain on our traffic, and the strain on our school systems. So although I really want to protect our neighborhoods and protect our history, I very much want to make sure to increase development where we need it. And what I mean by that is really the blighted areas. So think of with Highway 9 or Holcomb Ridge, where we have vacant strip malls. These are the areas where I really want to focus our development instead of really approaching our neighborhoods. And with that, so I appreciate you taking time to listen.
Mr. Palermo.
So luckily for me, I was looking at the audience, and about half of the people here are already supporters of mine, which I really appreciate. I want to apologize. I'm actually going to address the other half that I haven't spoken with yet. I have a big request for you. Please, when you're thinking about on November 3rd who you want to vote for, please do not just make the decision based off of this one evening. What I really ask you is, please, on my flyers outside, I have my phone number, I have my email, please reach out to me, please speak with me. This is why I have such a great base of support, even though I just met them really during this campaign. I really am asking you that instead of just looking at just this evening and really making a decision on who you want to serve you for the next 4 years, please, in addition to speaking with me, please look at really what's happened in really the last 4 years, last 8 years. Please decide and look to yourself if you really love what you see in parts of Holcomb Ridge and Highway 9, if you love what's happened around Goulding Place, or the fact that Dolphin House at any time can be built with 5 houses around there right now today, or if you like that much higher density development townhouses everywhere. So please speak with me. I appreciate your time today.
Thank you.